Joining this session. My name is Jérôme Montigny. I'm working in Continental Automotive in Toulouse, so not so far from there. Today I want to present our return of experience about the MBAC solution Capella. So just short introduction about our Continental Corporation Group. So it's a quite old and huge company. You may know the tires production in Continental, but maybe you don't know about most of the important part, which is the development of automotive parts. So today we are producing parts for most of the car makers in the world. 75% of the cars which are produced today have at least one Continental equipment inside. So we have three main automotive divisions, which are powertrain, chassis, safety, and interior. I'm working in the interior division. So in the interior division, our mission is to inform the driver and the passenger via different HMI, for example. We are producing and we are connecting the car to the outside world, like devices, smartphone for example, but also to the infrastructure or to other vehicles. So for that we are producing a lot of different systems and components. Some example of these solutions, the over-the-air update solutions. We provide some connectivity over the air, for example, to reprogram directly the different components which are in the car. We have also this equipment, which is the multifunctional smart device terminal, which is also produced in Toulouse. This terminal for wireless charging and NFC functionality inside your car, so you don't have to connect directly your smartphone. You will have automatic charging and automatic connectivity with your dashboard. Other solutions we are producing in Toulouse are smart access solution. So as you can see, the idea is to let your smartphone in your pocket and you have directly access to the car without any key, and you are able for sure to start your car. So beyond this kind of solution, for sure you have different applications, like application for rental companies or for car sharing. So as you see, this kind of new solutions leads us to have more and more connected systems. So we are clearly now in the Web 3 of our developments. So we are coming from mechatronics components and closed system, and now we are developing connected system with associated mobility services. So for sure it's a new challenge because the systems are more complex to produce. So for that, we investigate to have a new approach to improve our process, the quality and the cost of our system. By using a new approach, for example, by looking at the open source community projects and thinking about having different and alternative solutions for the tools and system engineering tools and the associated methodologies. So clearly today our approach is to think about open source tooling compared to the traditional approach we used to have with in-house development and commercial tools. With this approach, we face some multiple problems like efficient traceability between all the different applications and data we have to manage. So we decided to investigate what is inside the Eclipse Foundation. Just as a reminder, we are a solution member of Eclipse. And when we are considering the Eclipse Foundation, you may know that there is different working groups, and one of them is the Polarsys working group, which includes two main solutions, which are Papyrus and Capella. So what is interesting in this approach is that the different partners, which are part of this working group, want to share their development costs and to share the innovation and the different technologies. So it is something which is very interesting. And we wanted to investigate the Capella solution. So the aim of this presentation is to show you how we work for now 2 years and a half with the open source solution hosted by this working group. So maybe you may know the Capella story. So Capella is coming from the Thales group. What is interesting in this approach is that besides Capella, there is 10 years of experience in Thales group about MBSE tooling and methodologies. And most important thing is that the tool has been designed in collaboration with the operational users. So with the end user, which is very important for us, because they address directly the needs at user level, and they explore and they investigate this solution in a multiple context, multiple safety critical embedded system, like the ones we have in the automotive industry. So as I said, we decided to evaluate Capella. What is very interesting in Capella is that inside the tool, the Arcadia methodology is associated, is integrated inside the tool. So it's one of the main MBSE pillar to have a method associated to the tool. It's not only having a UML CCML tool, a standard UML CCML tool. It's to have, beside this tool, an Arcadia methodology integrated. The second driver for us when we decided to evaluate this tool was the fact that inside we are able to clarify the user needs for our new intelligent transportation system, and we can formalize this need inside the operational analysis level. So compared to traditional UML CCML tool, this formalism is very interesting. And the last driver was to challenge the efficiency of our current MBSE solution we have in Continental, and to see if Capella can enhance our approach for that. So to summary, our goals are there. We want to have an MBSE approach where the model is used at the very beginning of the project, including when we are speaking and exchanging with our customers at the early beginning of the project, so when we receive some requests for quotation. So we want to collaborate with our customers and to deeply understand what are their needs and to be able to formalize their needs inside the model. For sure, we want to ensure that the models we are producing are reusable from one project to the other. And we want to set up a collaborative environment so that we improve the global R&D efficiency inside our departments. So this evaluation process is summarized in this page. So as I said, we started 2 years and a half ago by internal trainings, internal communication, and some proof of concept in one department. Then we see that, as expected, we improve our efficiency in terms of development compared to the traditional centric development approach we used to have. document-centric approach we used to have. So the year after, so it was last year, we decided to do two main steps. So the first one was to what I call the setup, so to define some infrastructure and to define integrated development environment in Eclipse. I will detail these two main steps just after. We initiate some collaboration with the PolarSys members like Thales, OBEO, Artal, PAFC, so that we can succeed in this definition of the infrastructure and the definition of the IDE. And we started to provide some good results to our management. So based on this setup, we done some piloting in different projects worldwide. So as the one I was presenting at the beginning, like the smart access system or the TPMS system, which is tire pressure monitoring system. So we start to do some piloting and to do some operational projects in a multi-user and multi-location context. We started also, based on this new approach, some reviews with our customers. This year we went in a world phase in more projects like the network devices project or the multifunctional smartphone terminal project. And we started to elaborate some requirements with the PolarSys members. So to have some connection between Capella and other tools for variant management, requirement engineering, and so on. We started some discussion to be a member of the eClarity consortium. So eClarity is a consortium which is dedicated to Capella developments. And we think about having some implementation of this eClarity project in the coming years. So what about the setup? The main idea was to evaluate Capella, but in our industrial context, we wanted to have this MBAC solution connected to the existing areas or the different domains we used to have when we are doing system development, like requirement engineering, change management, configuration management. So here the main idea was to provide to the system engineers a complete framework, including the connection between all these tools. So one of the problem I was mentioning before was that we have a lot of tools which are not so much interconnected. So here we have a continuous workflow between the different activities that the system engineer has to deal with. So based on that, we define and we update the associated process, so where we connect the different activity between model-based engineering, requirement engineering, and variant management. So this piloting was engaged in different R&D locations of Continental worldwide. So we started first for sure in Toulouse in France, but then a lot of different departments in different countries joined this piloting. So to be able to work in a collaborative way, so you may know that when we are doing such developments, we are doing the team are not only in Toulouse, but we have teams all over the world, and all these teams shall work together. So we define a collaborative working environment with Team for Capella from OBEO, and we succeed to have this collaboration workflow. For example, between France and Germany, and between France and Romania. And this setup today is working well, and we have a lot of engineers which are working in the same system model for their projects, whatever their location. So clearly here we are saving a lot of time because we are working on the same server, on the same database, so we don't have to reconcile or to do any fragmentation of our models. What is interesting in this approach is that all the administration tasks are completely hidden for the end user. So we have a dedicated administrator that manage the database, the server, and all these jobs are done by Jenkins jobs. I was mentioning that we want to improve our process. So today in our organization, our development is based on what we call a reuse repository approach. So the main idea is to maximize the reuse between the different projects. So as soon as we have a new project, we don't want to start from scratch. So we have a reuse approach associated to a variant management approach. So the main idea is to implement this reuse approach with the toolchain we have decided. So we are working with Capella, but we are working also for that with Pure Variant tool. We define together with Pure System and Thales Capella connector for Pure Variant. So as you can see here, what is interesting to manage this product line aspect is that we are able to modelize our system in a generic way, and then we are able to derive different variant realization of the system. So in this example, we can choose the different technologies, and the framework is able to produce the corresponding system architecture for the variant project. Another view of this product line approach and another view of the connection we are doing with Pure Variant. So we are using the capabilities of Capella to implement realization links between the different layers of Capella, which are defined by the Arcadia methodology. So concretely speaking, here we can do a mapping between one feature in the feature model of Pure Variant and an operational activities in the Capella model. And automatically, as you can see, after transformation, after derivation, we will be able to produce the corresponding variant model, and the connector will propagate the and will use the realization links to propagate the derivation. So here we are winning a lot of time in coupling the variant model and the system model in Capella. An associated concept to this approach is what we call the asset management. So as I said, when we are starting a new project, we don't want to start from scratch. So we are today implementing this asset management so that when we are starting a new system model in Capella, we can reuse assets definition which are managed by the asset manager. So here we have a coupling, full coupling to address our reuse approach and our variant management approach. You may know that in the automotive industries, for each OEM, for each car maker, there is a lot of variants, and this variability we have to handle is one of our main activities. So, just to summarize this piloting phase and the different feedbacks we receive from the different architects inside our company. Today, clearly, compared to the commercial tool we used to have for MBSE, we have seen that we cover and we overcome the gaps we have identified in the past, mostly due to the integration of the Arcadia methodology inside the tool. Inside the tool, you have automatic transition, you have validation rules, and so on, that are a good help for the system engineer. The second topic is the usability of the tool. So as I said, we are working in an industrial context. So for us, it's important that the tool is user-friendly, ergonomic, it doesn't crash, and is able to manage large models. As I was mentioning, the fact that we succeed to have this collaboration working between different locations and between different teams save a lot of time in terms of development. So we don't have to fragment our models, and we don't have to reconcile our different models. So we are winning a lot of time with this approach with Team for Capella. For sure, one of our objectives was to enhance the communication on one side with our customer and on the other side with the domains we are addressing at system level. So domains are hardware development, software development, mechanical developments. So by having a shared model and a reference model in a centralized with a centralized approach, we enhance this communication internally as well. The point that we have to go on are the interface of Capella with other tools for simulation or for connection with AUTOSAR models. So it's precisely what we want to do in the future. So the next steps, here you have a short overview which has been modelized in Capella. You can see in orange where we are today. So we have connected MBSE solution with PLE variant management solution, so Capella and Pure Variants. We have a connection with Jiren Git for change task management and configuration management. We established a connection with our requirement engineering tool, which is DORS. And the next step are the possibility to connect to domain tools by doing some transformation of the models, or by implementing some different viewpoints to address the different domain topics. And to do so, we decided to join the Clarity Consortium. So this ecosystem is focused on the MBSC solution Capella. And we should start all this development in the next eClarity project, which should start beginning of next year. And this eClarity project is oriented towards automotive development and automotive features. So it's one of the reasons why Continental France and Continental Austria decided to join this consortium. So thanks for your attention, and don't hesitate to evaluate this session, and I'm ready for your question if you have some questions. Is there some question about this evaluation? No? You understood everything? Okay, so thanks for joining again this session, and I'm staying there this afternoon, so if you have any question later on, we can discuss together. Thank you.